How are you doing? Once again, I am always glad that you're tuning in to Children's Ministry. I'm so glad that you're here, and I know that you will be blessed by the Word of God on today and knowing what He has, the plans and the purpose that He has for you. So let's get started. Get your Bibles, your tablets, whatever you have your Bible on, and we're going to get into His Word on today. We're in the book of James, studying about James, so let's be open up with prayer. Heavenly Father God, we just come thank you for this day, Lord. Thank you that God, as we're studying in your word, that your Holy Spirit will bring revelation of truth to us, God, opening the eyes of our understanding, that we will know, God, your word that you have for us on this day, Father God. Thank you. In your Son Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, faith kids. So we have been talking. I know you enjoyed the message on last week talking about tongue tamer, that we have to control, have self-control over our tongues, over the things that we say. And then we also talked about persevering and don't stop, don't quit, that you push through and continue on, that we never give up in God, right? And so now on today, we're going to talk about becoming wise. So as we're there in the book of James, are you already there? We're going to be in James chapter 3, talking about becoming wise. All right. So our memory verse is verse number 17. So we'll go down and read that, and then we'll come back up. So in James chapter 3, verse 17, it reads, "But the wisdom from above is first all pure. It is also peace-loving, gentle at all times, and willing to yield to others. It is full of mercy and good deeds. It shows no favoritism and is always sincere." So that's your memory verse for this week, Faith Kids, James chapter 3, verse 17. So we're talking about becoming wise. And what does that mean to me, to you, Faith Kids? It's having wisdom, and not just wisdom, like the wisdom of the world, because there's two kinds of wisdom. There is heavenly or godly wisdom, and then there's earthly wisdom. And we want to have heavenly, godly wisdom in our life. So let's go back up to verse number 13, and we'll begin there and get into God's word for us on today. "If you are wise and understand God's ways, prove it by living an honorable life, doing good works with the humility that comes from wisdom." All right, in the scriptures, what did it tell us that wisdom is? It says that if we're going to be wise, if we're going to have wisdom, we have to do what, Faith Kids? It says we have to prove it by living an honorable life, doing good works with the humility that comes from wisdom. So we have to do something. We ask God for His wisdom, but we have to do something. And we read in our memory scripture what wisdom is. Wisdom is pure. Wisdom is peace-loving. Wisdom is yielding to others or submissive. Wisdom is having mercy. Wisdom is doing good deeds. Wisdom is showing no favoritism. You're not impartial, and it is sincere. So as we continue on, read verse 14. "But if you are bitterly jealous and there is selfish ambition in your heart, don't cover up the truth by boasting and lying. For jealousy and selfishness are not God's kind of wisdom. Such things are earthly, unspiritual, and demonic." So earthly wisdom is what? Jealousy, selfishness. That's the earthly kind of wisdom. But we know we have the heavenly or the God kind of wisdom. And it shows the other things we talked about, being sincere and being pure. So we do not want to have earthly wisdom that is, you know what, thinks of you only. You're only concerned about me, I. That is selfish. That is not God's wisdom for us. So let's continue on. "For wherever, verse number 16. "For wherever there is jealousy and selfish ambition, there you will find disorder and evil of every kind. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure, It is also peace-loving, gentle, and at all times willing to yield to others. It is full of mercy and good deeds. It shows no favoritism and is always sincere. And those who are peacemakers will plant seeds of peace and reap a harvest of righteousness. Again, faith kids, having the wisdom of God. And so you ask, okay, we have to have this wisdom of God, you know, being peace loving, being pure, being sincere, and not impartial. But how do we even get wisdom? Well, the scripture tells us in James chapter 1 that if we ask God, who gives us freely and generously his wisdom, that's how we get it. You ask God to receive his wisdom. You know, Heavenly Father, fill me with your wisdom on this day. And he will. It says that he will give it to you generously and freely without rebuke or reproach. So we just ask God for his wisdom and then to operate, and we operate in it. And when we know that we're operating in God's wisdom, we know that we're not selfish. It's not about our own self. We know that we're operating in sincerity, that we're truth. It's the truth. We're operating in purity, meaning that we're operating in the things of God. So that's a sign that we're doing, we have God's wisdom, heavenly wisdom. And that's what we want to have. We want to become wise in the things of God. We want to have godly wisdom. So I have a little exercise I want to do with you, faith kids, on today real quickly. I am going to read a scenario, and I have my two signs here, and it says that either it is operating in that you're wise or you're not so wise. So as I read these things, fake kids, I want you to come with me and say whether it is wise or it is not so wise. So as I read this, it says, you and a group of friends are all having a sleepover, and they decide to watch a movie. However, they chose a movie that you know that you should not watch. You decide to go into another room and read a book instead of watching the movie. Are you being wise or not so wise? What's your answer, fake kids? Are you being wise or not so wise? Because they're watching a movie that's you know that you cannot watch, that is inappropriate, that is not bringing glory to God. And, or maybe your parents have already discussed this movie with you. So is that wise to go to another room, or should you stay there and watch the movie anyway? All right, what's your answer? Wisdom, right? You're showing godly wisdom because you know that you should not do those things. So it doesn't matter what everyone else around is doing. You know for yourself what you should be doing. So in that situation, if that movie, you know you should not be watching it, it was wise for this person to go to another room. Awesome, faith kids. How many got that answer for wisdom? Good. And that's another one. Let me read. It says, Jack is mad at his parents because he wants to go outside and play with his friends. And his parents told him that not right now, that he was unable to go outside to play with them. So Jack went up to his room, took one of his toys, and threw it at the TV. He ultimately broke the screen on the TV. Was Jack acting wise or not so wise? Was he wise, fake kids, or not so wise? What is your answer? Not so wise, right? He was not wise. It was not wise of him to get mad and get angry and throw things, right? He was not displaying what we say wisdom is. Wisdom is pure. Wisdom is sincere. Wisdom is peace-loving. Was he peace-loving by throwing those things? No, he was not peace-loving. And was he being submissive, yielding to others as he should? Was he yielding to his parents by when they told him no, he could not play? No, he was not. So he was not being wise. He did not make a wise decision in that scenario. So let's do one more, fake kids. It says, Rebecca walked into a room As the door closed behind her, she noticed that a woman on crutches was walking towards the door. Rebecca turned around and held the door open for the woman. Was Rebecca being wise or unwise? Okay, it says she went into a door and the door was closing. And as it was closing, she saw an elderly lady coming up. And she went back to hold the door open for the lady. Was she being wise or unwise, fake kids? Of course, we know, right? She was being wise. We're to what? Help others? That's being wisdom, the godly, heavenly wisdom. So she went back and helped her. So she was being wise. So fake kids, that's what you're supposed to do. When you're having situations and challenges, whether you're at school, whether you're online, with your friends, with family, whoever, always use godly wisdom. You've asked for his wisdom. God has given you his wisdom, and we're able to make wise decisions and wise choices because the Holy Spirit lives in you, fake kids, to help you make these decisions, make these choices, make wise choices. Use the wisdom of God. You have his wisdom in every situation and in every circumstance. So fake kids, I hope you had a great day on today. Thank you for tuning in. As always, every week, remember to meditate upon your memory verse this week, James 3, verse 17, telling you that you have the wisdom of God. And when you have God's wisdom, you display these things, purity and sincerity, no favoritism. You have this godly wisdom in your life. So I will see you on next week, fake kids, for another word from God for you. Have a blessed week. Bye.